In this video, I'll show you how to find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of a square matrix. Say A is a square matrix of order n. Now, in our last class, we discussed about the geometry behind eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So, if we summarize quickly the working rules that we discussed in the last lecture, then we can write that the characteristic polynomial denoted by delta t is written as determinant of A minus t into in. What is t? T is an indeterminate. T is an indeterminate. So you can actually consider this t, means roughly speaking, you can consider this t as a variable in this polynomial. Now you can understand this in means, this in means the identity matrix of order n. So if you expand this determinant, you will get a polynomial of degree n in t. We had seen in our last lecture that if my A is a 2 cross 2 matrix, say A11, A12, A21, A22, then we had seen in our last lecture that delta t can be represented as t square minus trace of A into t plus determinant of A plus determinant of A. Now, can you recollect what is this trace of A thing means? This trace of A means trace of any matrix is the sum of the leading diagonal elements. So here it will be A11 plus A22. And we further discussed in our previous lecture that if A is a 3 cross 3 matrix, say A is A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. If A is this, then the characteristic polynomial will be T cube, means we are getting this, you will get this if you expand this determinant for this matrix. I'm just writing the result of this expansion so that we can very easily solve problems by directly plugging in values in this result. So this will be T cube minus trace of A into T square plus A11, A22, A33, sum of these three. Now, can you tell me what this uppercase A represents? This uppercase A represents the cofactor of the corresponding element. That means this uppercase A11 is the cofactor of the element lowercase A11 into T plus, sorry, minus determinant of A. So using this formula, we can find out the characteristic polynomial of a 3 cross 3 determinant. And as an explanation of what is this, we can write that this Aii represents the cofactor, represents the cofactor of small a ii. That's it. We can think in this way, and in this case, trace of A, what is trace of A? Again, sum of the elements in the leading diagonal, that is A11 plus A22 plus A33. So this is your trace. This is this. So everything is understood. If we have a 3 cross 3 matrix to find out the characteristic polynomial, we will simply plug in values and we get this. Now the thing is, what do you mean by eigenvalue? Eigenvalue. What do you mean by eigenvalue of this A? What do you mean by eigenvalue of this A? Eigenvalue is the root of the characteristic equation. Eigenvalue is the root of the characteristic equation. That means I can write eigenvalues as roots of the characteristic equation That means delta t equals to 0. So eigenvalues will be the roots of the characteristic equation. I will simply characteristic equation is the characteristic polynomial equated with 0. So that is called the characteristic equation. So eigenvalues are the roots of this. So you can understand if I have a 3 × 3, if I have a 3 × 3 determinant, then I will have 3 eigenvalues because my characteristic polynomial will be a polynomial of degree 3 and the corresponding equation will be an equation of degree 3. So that will have 3 roots. So I will have 3 eigenvalues. Now the 3 roots can be all real. It can happen 1 real, 2 imaginary. Now if all are real, all can be same, all can be different, 2 of them can be equal, other can be distinct. So there are several possibilities depending on the problem. So this is how we find out the eigenvalue. Now next is eigenvector. Eigenvector is if lambda, if I consider for an eigenvalue, for an eigenvalue, eigenvector is defined as for an eigenvalue lambda, for an eigenvalue lambda, eigenvector is a vector x which is a non-null vector such that this A x is equal to lambda x. Means for any eigenvalue, that non-null vector which satisfies this relation Ax equal to lambda x is known as the eigenvector. For any non-null, for any eigenvalue lambda, that non-null vector which satisfies this relationship Ax equal to lambda x is known as the eigenvector. Actually, this line can further be simplified as A minus lambda I into Ax is equal to the null vector. If we write in this way, A minus lambda I into X is equal to the null vector. This form will be very useful in solving problems. So this is what we discussed in our previous class, and this will be our working formula for solving a problem. Now let us solve a problem. Let A is equal to this matrix 4, 1, minus 1, 2, 5, minus 2, 1, 1, 2. Then you have to find all the eigenvalues of A for the first part. And for the second part, find a maximum set S of linearly independent eigenvectors of A. That means we need to find out the eigenvectors accordingly. Then I'll tell you what the other words mean. Means linearly independent eigenvector and maximum set, what that means. Okay, fine. Let us solve one by one. First, let us try to find out all the eigenvalues. Okay. So if I have the formula once again, the formula that I wrote above, you can straight away find out the eigenvalues by treating characteristic polynomial. Then you can expand the determinant and do it, or you can directly plug in values in this particular formula. So I need to find out the trace of this matrix and all the cofactors of the leading diagonal elements and the determinant. So let us find that. So clearly here trace of A, can you tell me what will be trace of A? Trace of A will be sum of the elements in the leading diagonal. That is 4 plus 5, 9 plus 2, 11. So trace is 11. Next, A11. What is A11? A11 will be the cofactor of this particular element. That means I can think that I will strike off the first row, that means row and column containing this element, and I will consider the determinant of the value of the remaining matrix. That means the determined value of 5, minus 2, 1, 2, with the proper sign. The sign here, the notation for sign is for Aij, the sign will be minus 1 whole to the power I plus j. In that case, it is 1 plus 1 because I and j both are 1. So if we calculate, this will be 10 minus 2, that is equal to 10 minus 2, sorry, 10 plus 2, that is equal to 12. 10 minus of minus 2, that is 12. So A11 is 12. Similarly, you can calculate A22, that will be 4 into 2, 8. 8 minus, minus 1, so 9. So A22 will be 9. And similarly, if you calculate A33 will be what? A33 will be 20 minus 1, 1 into 2. So 20 minus 2, that is 18. A33 will be 18. Now, next, what remains? Determinant of A. Can you tell me what will be the determinant of A? Determinant of A. Can you calculate what will be determinant of A? Determinant of A will be 40 minus 2, so that is 38, minus 2 plus 5, minus 2 plus 5 is 40 minus 2, minus 2 plus 5 plus 8 minus 4, so that is 45. So determinant will be 45. Determinant of A will be 45. You can very easily check. So this is these are the values. Therefore delta t will be equal to, what will be t cube minus, let us quickly revisit the formula once again, t cube minus trace of A into t square plus the sum of the cofactors of the leading diagonal elements into t minus dt. So this will be t cube minus trace, what is the trace? 11 into t square plus sum of these three, 12 plus 9 plus 18, so that is 39. So that means plus 39 into t minus 45. So this is delta t. So this is my characteristic polynomial. Therefore, eigenvalues will be the roots of delta t equals to 0. Therefore, eigenvalues are the roots of, therefore, eigenvalues, I can write eigenvalues are the roots of t cube minus 11 t square plus 39 t minus 45 is equal to 0. Now, how to find out the roots of this cubic equation? The general method to find out roots of a cubic equation is known as Cardano's method, which will be a bit lengthy. That's why here we will apply a trial and error method to find one rational root. I mean, since it is a cubic equation, it will have three roots. So that means it will have at least one rational root. Now, we will try to figure out that rational root by trial and error method. After we find out that, then we will factorize this polynomial to get a quadratic polynomial. Then we can find out the other zeros of that quadratic polynomial. So we can find out all three roots in that way. Now the question is how to use the trial and error method. What value for t you will try? There is infinite number of choice, but I'll tell you something. If we consider a cubic equation, say the equation is a0 x cube plus a1 x square plus a2 x plus a3 equals to 0. If we consider this cubic equation, and if alpha, beta, gamma are the roots of this cubic equation, if alpha, beta, gamma are the roots of this cubic equation, then we can write that alpha into beta into gamma is equal to minus A3 divided by A0. Minus A3 divided by A0. Well, what are alpha, beta, gamma? Alpha, beta, gamma are the roots. Are the roots. So how this is going to help us? For this particular problem, which we have here, let us, if we consider that the roots are alpha, beta, gamma, for this particular problem, alpha, beta, gamma will be equal to minus. What is A3 in this particular problem? If you consider coefficients, for this particular problem, A0 is 1, A1 is minus 11, A2 is 39, A3 is minus 45. So alpha, beta, gamma will be minus of minus 45 divided by 1. So that is 45. So alpha, beta, gamma equal to 45. So you are getting that the product of three roots for this particular problem, the products of, for this particular equation, the product of three roots will be 45. So we can say on the basis of that, that a rational root of 1, will be among the factors of 45. That means I can consider plus minus 1, plus minus 3, plus minus 5, plus minus 9, plus minus 15, plus minus 45. So these are my candidates for trial and error method. Now if I try one by one, plus 1 will not satisfy this equation. Minus 1 will also not satisfy the equation. Plus 3, 27, 19. Yes, plus 3 is satisfying 1. Plus 3 is satisfying 1. T equals to 3 satisfies 1. Therefore, I can say T minus 3 is a factor. T minus 3 is a factor of this polynomial delta t. T minus 3 is a factor of this polynomial delta t. Now, what will be the other factor? I can simply figure out by doing a synthetic division. So if I do a synthetic division, this is my delta t. This is my delta t. So the coefficients are 1, minus 11, plus 39, minus 45. So if I do a division by 3, this is 1, this is 3, minus 11 plus 3. So 8, 8 into 3, 24. 8 into 3 is 24. Sorry, this is minus 8. So minus 8 into 3, minus 24. So minus 24, 39. That means 15. This is 0. 15 into 3, 45 minus 45, 0. Therefore, I can say actually here the polynomial will be, actually it has to be 0 because t minus 3 is a factor. So the remainder has to be 0. Therefore, I get a polynomial t square minus 8t plus 15. Therefore, equation 1, that is t cube minus 11t square plus 39t minus 45 equals to 0 implies one factor is t minus 3 and the other factor is t square minus 8t plus 15 equals to 0. Now, fantastic, 15 and minus 8, so minus 5, minus 3. So you can understand that this again can be factored as t minus 3 into t minus 3 into t minus 5, that is equals to 0, which implies t is equals to 3, 3, 5. So fine. So for part A, actually we are answering the first part of the question, that is part A. Let us consider this as part A. So for the first part of the question, we got the eigenvalues. So I will write, therefore, the eigenvalues are, therefore the eigenvalues are lambda 1 equals to 3, if I write in this way, and lambda 2 equals to 5. But remember, this lambda 1 equals to 3, this 3 is an eigenvalue of algebraic multiplicity 2, because it is a two-fold eigenvalue. Eigenvalue 3 and 5. So we need to remember, we can write it also. Lambda 1 equals to 3, we can write is an eigenvalue of algebraic multiplicity 2, and lambda 2 equals to 5 is of algebraic multiplicity 1. Now those kind of eigenvalues are known as simple eigenvalue. Lambda 2 equals to 5 is a simple eigenvalue. So fine, the first part is answered. So we got the eigenvalues. Now the second part. So to answer the second part, we need to find out the eigenvectors. Fine, let us find that. So there will be eigenvectors corresponding to these two eigenvalues. So firstly, let us find out for lambda equals to 3. For lambda equals to 3, if we find out, how to find out eigenvector, if we quickly recollect, eigenvector can be found out from this particular relationship. A minus lambda I operated with x is equal to 0, is equal to the null vector. So, okay, fine. So, if I do it, so that is A minus 3i. So, I can write A minus 3i, this matrix, multiplied with the vector x will be equal to the null vector. So, that means A minus 3i. What is my A? If I write once again, because that is written above, I don't want to scroll up always. So, it will be 4, 1, minus 1, 2, 5, minus 2, and 1, 1, 2. This is my A. So, A minus 3i means 3 should be reduced from each of the elements in the leading diagonal. So, I will get a matrix that is, that will be 1, 1, minus 1, 2, 3, minus 2, and I'll get 1, 1, minus 1. 1, 1, minus 1, 2. Sorry. This has to be 2. This has to be 2. Because 5 minus 3, so that is 2. I don't know why I wrote 3. I wrote this 3 actually somehow. Anyway, so 2, 2 minus 2, 1, 1 minus 1. So that, let x be x1, x2, x3. That is equal to 0, 0, 0. Fine. So we need to solve this system. So if we do a Gaussian elimination here, if I try to do a Gaussian elimination here, the elimination will be pretty simple. R2 prime will become R2 minus 2R1, and R3 prime will become R3 minus R1. So if we do this operations, then I'll get 1, 1, minus 1. It will be 0, 0, 0. Okay, it will also be 0, 0, 0. Fine. So x1, x2, x3, that is equals to 0, 0, 0. Now, this particular matrix is known as the characteristic matrix. This particular matrix, whatever you have got as A minus 3i, characteristic matrix. Now, this tells us that the rank of, if I denote it by M, this gives this particular operation tells us that rank of m is equal to what will be the rank of this characteristic matrix? The rank will be 1. Therefore, the number of independent solutions that this will have, therefore the number of independent or linearly independent solutions, the number of independent solutions will be what? Will be 3 minus 1, that is equal to 2. 3 minus 1, 3 is the size of the matrix or the number of variables. 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. Or in other words, if you think other justification is in this reduced form after Gaussian elimination, you have one pivotal variable. Means if I consider the variables as x1, x2, x3, and if I consider the pivotal elements in the reduced matrix, so for x1, you got a non-zero pivotal element, that is 1. For x2, your pivotal element becomes 0. For x3, your pivotal element also becomes 0. So x2 and x3 will be your free variables, and x1 is a pivotal element. So these two free variables, x2 and x3, can take any value. And for that value of x2, x3, you will get a particular value for x1. So in this case, all values of x1 will depend on the value of x2 and x3. So that will not be independent. I will have only two independent variables, that is, two independent solutions corresponding to, in that sense, x2 and x3, the values that you are assigning for x2 and x3. So if I write this again in linear equation form, this matrix products, then I will get x1 plus x2 minus x3 is equals to 0. So simple, I'll assign some value to x2 and x3, which are my free variables. And I'll find out what is my x1, because x1 is the pivotal variable. So why x2, x3 free variable? Because I got 0 in the corresponding reduced matrix. So now let x2 is equal to, say, a, which is not equals to 0, because 0 is a very trivial case and which is a real number. And x3 is equals to b, which is again not equals to 0 and a real number. If that is the case, if we plug in the value of x2 and x3 in the above equation, we get, therefore, x1 will be what? X1 will be minus a plus b. Therefore, my vector x will be equal to x1, x2, x3. That means minus a plus b, a, b. That means we can write this as, this step is very important. We can write this as, if I take minus a common, this will be 1 minus 1, 0 plus b into, plus b into 1, 0, 1. Can I write it in this way? Where this a and b belongs to non-zero reals, means they are non-zero real numbers. So this, now I told you that I will get two linearly independent solutions. So now you can ask me, what are the two linearly independent solutions? You got the answer. The two linearly independent solutions can be taken as this two, or any multiple of 1 minus 1, 0, and a multiple of 1, 0, 1. So these two, either these two, or you can take any multiple of these two. It means any multiple of this one. If I call this vector as v1, and if I call this particular vector as v2, so your independent solutions, linearly independent solutions, will be v1, v2, or it will be some multiple of v1 and some multiple of v2. So that is, now we said that those vectors which satisfies this particular equation, those vector which satisfies this particular equation will be called as a those particular non-zero vectors x which satisfies this particular equation will be known as eigenvector. So from this calculation, what we have done, what will be my eigenvector? Pretty simple. V1 will satisfy that equation, V2 will satisfy that equation. So V1 will be an eigenvector, V2 will be an eigenvector, or any multiple of V1 is an eigenvector. So if V1 satisfies that equation, any multiple of V1 will also satisfy that equation, or any multiple of V2 will be an eigenvector, or their linear combination will also be an eigenvector. So I can write, therefore, for lambda 1 equals to 3, V1 equals to 1 minus 1, 0, V2 equals to 1, 0, 1, or any multiple of V1 or any multiple of V2 or any linear combination of V1 and V2 are eigenvectors of A for lambda 1 equals to 3. So that means you got an infinite number of eigenvectors. Actually, that is correct. For a particular eigenvalue, you will get infinite number of eigenvectors, and which are given in this way. So 1 minus 1, 0, or 1, 0, 1, or any linear combination. Now, see, I have discussed in my previous class that the number of linearly independent eigenvectors, or means actually you can, if you think in this problem, 1 minus 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, or any of their linear combinations. Now, where all those vectors will lie, 1 minus 1, 0, multiple of 1 minus 1, 0, and multiple of 1, 0, 1, and linear combinations of these two, where those vectors will lie? Those vectors will lie in the space spanned by these two vectors. So all vectors in the space spanned by these two vectors will be eigenvectors of this matrix A corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda 1 equals to 3. So that means that space along with the null vector, remember one second, I made a mistake here, or any non-zero multiple, I need to write. Because if you say it is zero, the thing becomes trivial. Or any non-zero. Let me write it. So all those vectors which are lying on the space spanned by these two linearly independent vectors along with the null vector is known as the eigenspace. That space along with the null vector is the eigenspace of this matrix A corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda 1 equals to 3. Now the point is the rank of that eigenspace is known as the geometric multiplicity of this eigenvalue. Now rank of that eigenspace is equal to the number of linearly independent eigenvectors that were same. The number of linearly independent eigenvectors and the rank of the space spanned by those eigenvectors will be same. So here we can say the geometric multiplicity, if I write one line further, the geometric multiplicity of this lambda is equal to lambda 1 equals to 3 is 3, and which is, sorry, here it is 2, because I have means the eigenvalue is 3. Sorry, the eigenvalue is 3. The geometric multiplicity will be 2, which is equal to 2, which is same as the algebraic multiplicity. multiplicity. Now, if you have an eigenvalue where the geometric multiplicity is same as the algebraic multiplicity, then that eigenvalue is known as a regular eigenvalue. So it is a regular eigenvalue. Here, the algebraic multiplicity is same as the geometric multiplicity. So that's it for lambda 1 equals to 3. These are the eigenvectors corresponding to lambda 1 equals to 3. Now, one more case is left when lambda 1 equals to 5. Let for lambda 2, let us call that lambda 2. Lambda 2 equals to 5. If lambda 2 equals to 5. Then similarly, I have to solve. Similarly, we have to solve ax is equal to 5x. Now, if you plug in the values here, what is your a? Let me write a once again. So a is for, again, 4, 1, minus 1, 2, 5, minus 2, 1, 1, 2. So this is my a. So if ax equal to 5x, that means if I consider the thing that a minus 5i operated into x is equal to null matrix, is equal to the null vector. It will be a column matrix. So I will get, if I subtract 5 from every place, I will get what? 4 minus 5. So minus 1, 1, minus 1, 2, 0, minus 2, 1, 1, minus 3. So I'll get this one into x. X means say x1, x2, x3. That is equals to, again, 0, 0, 0. So now if we find out, if we try to do elimination by Gaussian elimination technique, if we apply, then my operations will be r2 prime will change to r2 minus, sorry, plus 2r1, and r3 prime will become r3 plus r1. So that means I will get, minus 1, 1, minus 1. So it will be 0, I'll get 2, and plus 2r1, so minus 4. Here I will get 0, 2, minus 4. Oh, fine. 0, 2, minus 4 into x1, x2, x3 is equals to 0, 0, 0. So this. Now this is quite clear that the next step will be, r3 double prime will change to r3 minus r2, r3 prime minus r2 prime. So this will be, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 0, 2, minus 4, 0, 0, 0 into x1, x2, x3. That is equals to 0, 0, 0. Now, can you tell me what is the rank of your characteristic matrix? If I consider this matrix to be M here, therefore, the rank of, if this matrix here considered M, therefore, what is the rank of this characteristic matrix? If you look at this particular form, you know that the rank of this will be 2. Therefore, number of independent solutions, will be what? Solutions will be 3 minus 2, that is equal to 1. And it's quite clear also from the other logic that you got, corresponding to your pivot, means your variable x1, you got a pivotal element. For variable x2, you got a pivotal element. But you got, you got a non-zero pivotal element in these two cases, but in this case, you got a zero pivotal element. So x3 will be your free variable. So here, x3 is your free variable. So let x3 is equals to a. If we consider x3 is equal to a, my equations, if I write them in equation form, my equations are minus x1 plus x2 minus x3 is equals to 0. And I'm getting 2x2 minus 4x3 equals to 0. That means x2 minus 2x3 is equals to 0. Therefore, x3 equals to a means x2 will be equal to 2a and x1 will be equal to a. x1 will be equal to a. Therefore, what will be my eigenvector? What will be the solution of that particular equation? Therefore, x can be written as equal to a 2a a. That means, what is this a? This a is not equals to 0, and this a belongs to real set of reals, means it is a non-zero real number. So I can write a belongs to the set of non-zero real numbers. So x is equal to this. Therefore, x can be written as equal to a into 1 to 1, where this a is a non-zero real numbers. So likewise, the previous case, what I can say now, I can say that this x satisfies this equation. That means this x, which are of this form, will be my eigenvectors. Any x which is of this form will be my eigenvector. Therefore, for lambda equals to 5, 1, 2, 1, or any non-zero multiple, multiple of 1, 2, 1 are eigenvectors. Can you tell me what will be the geometric multiplicity of 5, lambda equals to 5? Now, we have only one linearly independent eigenvector here, means one linearly independent solution here, or that means the rank of the eigenspace will be 1. Therefore, in this case, the geometric multiplicity is equals to what? 1. Now, you can remember that this is the algebraic multiplicity also. Multiplicity is also 1. So in this case also, they are same. So that means this is also a regular eigenvalue. So we have got all the eigenvectors. Now the question is what? Question is, we have to form a set S of all the linearly independent eigenvectors of A. Now, A has we got three eigenvalues. Of the three, two are same. So that means A has two eigenvalues. One eigenvalue, that is lambda 1 equals to 3, is of multiplicity 2, and the other lambda 2 equals to 5 is of multiplicity 1. So if I consider lambda 1 equals to 3, I can clearly write any two linearly independent eigenvectors from lambda 1 equals to 3. And the eigenvectors for lambda 1 equals to 3 will be either this v1 or this v2, or any multiple of v1 will be linearly independent with any multiple of v2. So instead of taking multiples, I can straightway take v1 and v2. Or I can take, some multiple of v1 and some multiple of v2. They will be linearly independent. And straightway, one from lambda equals to 5. Sorry, this will be lambda 2. One from lambda 2 equals to 5. So either this 1 to 1 or any multiple of 1 to 1. Therefore, I can write a set S as described above two from lambda 1 equals to 3. Let me check once again. 1 minus 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So these two are any multiple of these two. So let us take these two, considering the multiple to be 1. So 1 minus 1, 0. The other one we have read is 1, 0, 1. 1, 0, 1. And say one from this one straight away. One from this one straight away. That is 1 to 1. That is 1 to 1. Now, these three will be linearly independent. Why these three will be linearly independent? Because these one, although chosen from the same eigenvalue, but they are so chosen that they are linearly independent. We have seen in the derivation. And these one will also be linearly independent in this set because eigenvectors corresponding to distinct eigenvalues are linearly independent. So as a set, these three are linearly independent as a set. So this is a set containing linearly independent eigenvectors. Now you can form infinite number of these kind of sets. So you can form another set where you will keep some multiple of the first one, some non-zero multiple of the first one, some non-zero multiple of the second one, and some non-zero multiple of the third one. That will also be a linearly independent set. And maximum means this is the maximum possible number of linearly independent vectors that you have kept in one set. If you plug in one more vector, then certainly that can be expressed as a linear combination of these three. So in that sense, this is maximum. That's why that is what was asked in the question, that find the maximum set of linearly independent eigenvectors of A. So this is how we find out eigenvectors, algebraic multiplicity, geometric multiplicity, and this is how we can form a set of linearly independent eigenvectors. The calculation was a bit lengthy, but I was explaining and doing the calculation. That's why it took so much of time. When you will be doing it in your own, you can do it just like that. It's very simple once you understand the concept. So now I'll be giving two problems for you to solve. The problems are find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of these two matrices. 1, 0, 0, I, 2, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 2, minus 1, and 1, minus 1, 2. When you will be finding out the eigenvalues and eigenvectors, also check the algebraic multiplicity and geometric multiplicity and repeat the task that we have done in the previous problem. You can solve it exactly in the same way as we have done the previous problem. Just be careful about this first problem. You can see that one element of your matrix is imaginary, but don't bother about that. Give the same treatment as we have treated as we have done the previous problem. So solve the two problems. If you face any difficulty, if you have any doubt, if you have any query, you can ask me in the you can raise your question in the comment section below, and you also let me know the solution in the comment section below. I'll be waiting to hear from you. So that's it for this video. Solve the problem, let me know the answer, and take care.